So in this video, I'm gonna do another design tutorial, and this time I'm gonna use the website Creative Fabrica. I share on Twitter a lot the free bundles that Creative Fabrica has every day. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to use that, the SVGs, as well as how to use graphics on their site. So I'm gonna mash the two together. I think this can be really powerful, especially if you don't draw your own stuff, because there's so many graphics on there that's kind of almost ready, and in fact a lot of them are already done, but I'm going to show you how to take one and kind of mash it up with something else so that you don't use the same thing everybody else has access to. So let's get into Creative Fabrica right now. I'm going to show you the free bundle that I shared today, and I'm going to use something from there as well as another graphic. All right, so here we are on Creative Fabrica. You can see right there, just tons of stuff. I've talked about this before, but we're just going to talk about graphics, but you can see there's way more than graphics: fonts, images, 3D photos, tools, POD stuff. They have bundles and stuff, and they also have a bunch of freebies. I would check this out if you're wanting some freebies. I mean, they have a ton. They have so many, they have to do it in sections. So yeah, a lot of cool stuff. Speaking of freebies, I often post these when I see something really good, like this one. So I posted this today. Here's a free bundle. So if you click on here, if you follow me on X or Twitter, you'll see the free ones that I try and post daily, because they do have free bundles every day, which is incredible. Just click on this one and you'll see how many, like, it's amazing that there's 12 parts to this free, that a bundle is so big that it has all of these things, and it's free, which is, I don't know how they do it, honestly, but let me show you how to do it. So there's 20 days. This bundle will be gone in 20 days. So you still have time to use this. We're going to use this one right here. I could download all of part one, or I could just come in here and download this one. But let me do that. I'm pretty sure that's part of part one. So I'm going to do that. You can see it downloads right there to my downloads folder. And let me show you what that looks like. All right, so here's my downloads folder. It's a zip because there's so much in it. I double clicked on it, clicked in here. You can see all of these. And I believe it's the, let me check for sure. It's the Farmhouse Halloween Round. Oh, it's not that one. Let me just click on this and see if we can do that too. Okay, we can do that too. So I'm just gonna download this. I wanted to do these round ones because I think having that circle is a really good idea. Just makes it easy on a t-shirt. And I kind of have some ideas for this already. So let me do the download thing again. Okay, so there's the farmhouse one. I double clicked and these are SVGs. And when I come in here, I can do SVGs, but you can see it's all different styles. You can do EPS, PNG, if you don't want to do SVGs. I like SVGs because then we can edit it in Affinity Designer. And you can look at this, there's 20 of them right here. So we're gonna do that. Also, I'm gonna do one that has to do with coffee. So I'm gonna close this and we'll go back to Creative Fabrica and type in here. Now, this will not be free. You'll have to sign up to get this one, but I'll show you how to do, because you can still do some freebies and do that. But I want to show you, if you had an account, there's always sales here. There's a Halloween sale right now, in fact, and I'll put a link in the description on Creative Fabrica if you want to use this. But let me show you how you would use this if you had an account. I'm going to do Halloween, or maybe Witch Coffee. That's the one I want to do, Witch and Coffee. So you'd search like this if you're searching for something, or you can just go through the homepage. If you see something on the homepage, that's great too. Oh, did I not spell? I think I didn't spell coffee right. Which, C-O-F-F-E-E. Let's do that and search. Okay, great. So you can see a bunch of different Which Coffee. And the one I have is round like this, and it kind of looks like that one, but we're gonna do something different. I want this one right here because I want to use that in the middle instead of this one's pretty cool too. Man, which one looks more like, this looks more like iced coffee. This one looks like coffee or hot chocolate. You know what? The good thing is I can use both. So I'm going to come in here and I'm going to download because I have access to all of them, and I can go back. And then do this one and download. You can see because I have access, have the full year subscription, I can do both. So let's do both and see which one looks better. This is gonna be good because we're gonna change it and not use that exactly, because we wanna do something different that somebody else doesn't have. Now we can kind of mix match it. It won't look like this either. Remember, we're gonna use the free round part and then take out the middle and then substitute it with this. So same thing, when we go to the downloads, it's gonna be these zip files too. We're just gonna double click on those, and there's the PNG, double click on this. And this one actually is a SVG too. So we're gonna see how it works. This is good. So we're gonna see how it works with a PNG, which I can edit, and an SVG, which I can edit. So let's get into Affinity Designer now. I'm gonna show you how to drag it in, how to open these in Affinity Designer, and how to mix and match the things that we've seen. All right, so here I am in Affinity Designer. I just opened it up so you can see the size. What we're gonna do first is go to New. I'll move this here so you can see it. I have Merch by Amazon preset. If you don't have that, you can just type in here 4500 by 5400, 300 DPI, which doesn't really matter because it's pixels, but that's okay. Just put that in and hit create, and you're gonna see the size right there. So next thing we're gonna do is, I have my downloads folder right here. We're gonna drag in a few things. So this one right here, if you're following along, Witches Brew House Stop and For a Spell, I'm gonna drag this in here. And then we're gonna drag the SVG of the other one in here. This one, it's really big. So I'm gonna move that. I'm scrolling out, boom, in here. Whoops, I missed the, that moved away. Let's bring it in again. It's behind here now. I'll move it, there we go. Okay. Last one, this PNG, let's drag it in here. Okay, I'll close this. So now we have these three things here, and I don't know if I'm gonna be able to use the PNG. I could crop it, let's see what happens. Oh, I could mask it, yes, we'll try that. But if we click on here, you'll notice something. When I bring it in, it actually brought in like a copy of it. So this opened up, and you may have that in Affinity Designer. The way around that is, I'm gonna copy all of this right here and hit Command C. I'll go back in here, and this is just a copy. So I'm gonna delete that one, but then come in here and paste it. Now this is the real thing. If I double click on here, I can actually change it in here. It's not a copy. And in fact, I'm gonna remove this witch out and delete it. And then we're gonna replace it with one of these things. Okay, so I believe the same thing's gonna happen here. I double click, yes. Same thing, but what I wanna do is I only want the middle, so I'm gonna take this away and take this away, take these guys away. So you can see it's an SVG, and I can remove stuff now, which I won't be able to do with the PNG, but because this is a SVG, I can remove or edit. I can even like change the points on this. Like if this was something I needed to change, I can totally change that. And I'll show you what I mean. We're actually gonna do that with some of the letters in the circle. So let's move these. Oops. I just want the cup. So let's see, there we go. And yeah, that's fine. I'm gonna copy that, and I'm gonna go back here, remove that one, and hit Command V, perfect. I'm gonna group that, and you can see right away, I can put that right here, and I think that's different enough than what we were using. I'm gonna move these guys out just a little bit so we can fit this in there, like that, nice. And then I can put these guys back in, so put it here. Even turn it if I need to, move this one, and so on. Maybe I put this one here too. So we can move a bunch of stuff around. Now, if you want to really be different, we could change Coffee House, the font for that. So now these aren't text, so I can't just come in here and retype it. But what I could do is I could remove it and remove it, and then that could give it a different look too. So if I want to come in here and then use a different text, and I say coffee, right? And I want to do, I don't know, come in here, maybe not that text, but maybe something that you already have. You may not have these ones, but this one I'm using is called Bernard Condense, MT, Bernard MT. And I can put that here. And oh, coffee house, yes, coffee house. And I can stretch it a little bit or move it a little bit like that. All right, so that makes it a little different. And if you want, maybe I don't like this, how thin that is. Everything else is kind of thick. Well, maybe not this one. I could thicken that up too. So what I would do is I would come in here again. This is an SVG, right? I can come in here, select all these. Oops, not these ones. And this one, and then like make it thicker. Boom. You can see like that, and get rid of this. That's the nice thing about SVGs is I can come in here and even edit some of the other things. So you can see now that's a little thicker. I like that better, which is Brew. So this is different than what everybody else that got the free download and is gonna upload these to t-shirts possibly. Now you have something different and won't get a copyright strike from people that think that they own the artwork. Really, they don't, but if they're the first ones on there, they might be like, hey, I did that first, right? So change it up, make it different. You can do that by changing some of these things. Now we use this one. Now if you have a PNG, you notice I can't click on here. A couple of things you could do is you could, if you just want the middle part, is you could crop it. Let's see if it does a clean crop. Oh, that's pretty good. That's not bad. That's pretty good. Okay, so the only thing is this right here, enchant your day with every sip. That might not work. And in fact, let's see if it even fits in here. So let's, there's something else we can do here. So let's take this. I just copied, I did Option Shift Drag, made a copy. Let's take this out and let's see if this works in here. That kind of works. If it was smaller. Okay, so here's my workaround for PNGs. So you come in here and I'm gonna make a shape that goes around the whole thing and everything I want and excluding this. So this is what I'm gonna do. Pen tool right here, and I'm just gonna draw like this. So I'm coming around. I don't want that star, let's say. And this can be really quick, right? I'm not doing anything too hard. I'm just using the pen tool and making it real quick here. You notice I cut that off, so I'm gonna have to move that again. But yeah, look how fast that is. Okay, so we have that shape right there. Let's click on this and not do. We can take it out. So I don't need to crop it. So let's do the full thing. But I do need this right here. And I do need this. So I'm gonna move these to the front or the top right here, move to front. And now you see both there. And I'm gonna take the line off of the stroke off here. And so there's nothing, but I'm gonna put this inside the curve. Boom. Uh-oh, I missed one part there. Let me go back into the curve, come in here, and we can fix that like this. And maybe we didn't want that there. And maybe we want to get this up here. Whoops, I missed some of those things. There, we fixed it. Okay, so now it's still transparent. We'll see what it looks like. And we'll put that here. Whoops, let's move these guys up. In fact, let's move all of this middle part, which we can do pretty easily. I just hit delete there and delete there. Good. Okay. Now this is really cool. It's a lot different and looks great. One of the nice things about an SVG, though, besides a PNG, which is easy here, looks great and everything, but I'll show you the difference. SVG, I'm going to copy this one more time, and we're going to change the background. So let's say instead of a white background, we want a black background. So, that's the stroke. Fill here, right? Black. I'll actually make it gray so you can see. And so we can select all of these and make it white. And that's going to look great on a black t-shirt, right? Now we can't do the same thing here because this is a PNG. Watch what happens. Well, I think we can't. Let's see. Can we make this white? No, that's just a background, right? This? No. See, we can't change it. We'd have to change it in Affinity Photo or Photo P, not here in a Affinity Designer, unless I'm missing something. But we can change everything else really easily to white here, right? We can change it to any color we want. So that's kind of the difference. That's why I like working with SVGs. For PNGs, you'd have to go in and tweak it a little bit different. And I can show you how to do that in another video. But for Affinity Designer, you can't just click on it and change it like you can here with a SVG. So great for a black shirt here in Affinity Designer, but not so good here. So I think this one would be good. I'm gonna save this one and I'll show you how you would use it for print on demand. So I click on this, I'd remove the background, I'll hit Command Option Shift S, or come down here and File Export. You can see I'm exporting as a PNG selection only instead of artboard, and hit Export. And this is gonna save it. I can title it Coffee House or whatever you want to call it. Boom. I like turning this back to black so that I can see it later. And let me show you what it looks like. So there you go. Very simple. We did that in a few minutes here. I made changes to it so it doesn't look exactly like the free download, even though it's free. And I just like to do that so that it's different enough that it's not an exact copy of what everybody else has. But I think it's still a really cool thing for Halloween. Nice, good pun here. But we've changed it enough that it's different and now it's yours. That nobody should have this same exact thing, right? So there you go. That's how easy it is to create something using Creative Fabrica's different SVGs and PNGs. Now, let me know in the comments if you want to see more of these. Let me know also if you want to see how to change the color of a PNG. I didn't go over that here. You're going to have to use something like Photo P or Affinity Photo, and I can do a tutorial for that as well. If you haven't used Creative Fabrica yet, I'm gonna put a link in the description for you to go and try it out. You can get 10 free downloads with my affiliate link down there, and you can try it out just like how I did. You can just find something, download it for free, and use it. Either SVG, I would suggest SVG if you're using Affinity Designer. That way you can make changes, change the points and everything, and change the color really easily, like we just showed in this example. Thanks again for watching. If you want to see another design that I did with Creative Fabrica, I'll put that video right here as well so you can see more examples. Keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.